Hello everyone, welcome to Fijian Investment Trader. My name is Mr. Singh. XPeng, ticker symbol XPEV, EV company based in China. I'm excited. Apologies for not sending this video a couple of days early, but I'm sharing it with more updated news. I'm excited, so let's go. We're up high and 43.75 and we gapped down all the way to 42. Market opened up at $43, went higher 43, and then we pulled back at $42 and went higher of $43.50. And before the market closed, we just had a massive pullback all the way low at 42.75, but we're recovering on the after hours at $43. Okay, pretty neutral. Still down 2.35% for the day. That's $1.03 from the previous. But I'm excited about this company's growth, what they have been doing, which I'm going to talk right now on the growth, right? I always talk about growth. I hold NIO and XPeng. They're two of the EV companies that I have holding on the shares on that for the long-term purpose, because I believe these two companies are growing at a rapid pace. So XPeng tops the NEV brand in China for innovation and intelligence, says the JD Power survey. XPeng is top-ranked brand in the innovation of Chinese market service intelligence experience, surpassing Tesla, that JD Power said, released on August 5th. That's today. The local Chinese brand is ahead of the joint ventures of intelligence of 2021, especially a new car-making brands with outstanding technologies of innovation. Phenomenal, right? They're performing at the highest level, which is ranked at 615 points, ranked to 597. Tesla and Leora is 577 points. Folks, this company, I'm telling you guys, this company is another big EV company. You definitely don't want to miss out and sleep on it. So, also, today, CC praises XPeng, raises XPeng to $55. Folks, this company is a triple digits company in a couple of years from now, and I can definitely see that even sooner than that because it is a massive trend, right? CICC said it's raised its price target, XPeng today, by 19.6% for $55, which is an upside of 36% concerning the sales exceeding the expectation, right? Sales, what do you mean by sales? Let's talk about the sales, right? Trust me, I talk about a lot of growth and technical at the same time, which I really want to share. And this is, I didn't share it in a couple, 2 days ago, which I should have. My apologies once again, but let's go. I'm doing right now. So XPeng, what have XPeng has done in July? Well, XPeng has beat NIO on the sales of delivery numbers over 8,000. 7,931 was NIO. And we see that time and time, it was the kind of leading factor where NIO was always on the leading, which is the gray, right? So NIO is right here, which was always the leading factor on delivery of the vehicles. But month of July, it was being outproduced by XPeng and Li Auto. Li Auto made a massive run, right? Although close to over 8,500 vehicles compared to 8,100 was XPeng and 7,900 was roughly to NIO. So that's a phenomenal. Because they have the P7s vehicle, sedan vehicle options, right? Once you have that, there's a variety of people you can have the sales to have options to buy. Phenomenal, right? This is all pointing what, right? It's all pointing to the growth, folks. You see time and time, XPeng have 2020 has went up, right? Up high, right? It's going up, had a pullback on the delivery numbers, went high, right? I'm touching the delivery numbers for XPeng. You will see pullback, and then guess what? We have a high. Kind of reminds of the stock price, right, folks? Kind of reminder of the stock price, up and down, pullback, is drilling up, right? That's what we need, is a constant growth, right? We knew about the chip shortage happened here. massive pullback on that, right? When the news came out, and then they recovered really quickly, and they went pushed up high on the delivery numbers. So this is the trend of the delivery numbers you'll see for XPeng, and I'm excited about it, right? Let's talk about the technical side, what I'm seeing it, and what we're looking at, right? Also, folks, I have always seen it was usually like a $8 to $9 gap between NIO and Tesla, right? When the stock, in terms of stock price. But you look at NIO right now, it's sitting at $45.60. XPeng is $42.75, $3 difference. They are catching up on this price of the stock price, right? All the way low coming from $22, right? NIO dropped all the way to $30. They came from all the way to $23, rallied all the way to $46. Has a better recovery on the stock price as the NIO. No, right? Both these two companies are rock solid. I love these two companies. Both show growing in the Norway, better expansion in the Europe market, better delivery, better cars. You know, they're both doing at the highest level. Right now, XPeng is showing more better in terms of the stock price than NIO. So what are we looking at? What is the trend we're looking at, right? So on year to date, one day, you'll see that our 200-day moving average is the pink line. It's right here acting as support at $35.93. 60-day is showing at $39.04 and $41.49, which is our support level. It's sitting right up there, right? So all signs is pointing for uptrend, right? We already have the curve over RSI neutral pullback today, right? There's a lot of potential to run, right? And this is based on what I'm seeing. It is also, I'm going to show you a chart, right? Not the exact kind of theory on that. Kind of had a bullish from all the way from 47, came in all the way down for 36, right? This trend right here had a spike, you'll see. And we have to have a double bottom, which I've seen right here. One double bottom, two double bottom, right? A major pull. We have this spike, right? As you can see this spike right up here. Have this spike right up here. Expect a pullback, which we did today, you know, in testing, maybe a little bit more pullback to $39 level before another massive run. So we got to see if it kind of plays out with the double bottom on that to see how far the XPeng goes on the technical side, right? I wanted to quickly share with you guys in the chart perspective, but our support level, nothing changes. Pretty sits at a $41.49, right? It's sitting at $40.49, and then a resistance at $44.66. $44.66. Time and time we're getting rejected on that, but I'm okay trading in the channel. Or if we drop below $39.04, where you'll see a buyers will step in. Last time we did a couple of times, the buyers stepped in and pushed it all the way high. But our 200-day moving average sitting at $35.93, right? Gotta be certain things you gotta be careful is the Nasdaq is the all-time high today. You'll see on the year to date, I'm gonna go back that we went all-time high today, folks. All-time high. So we gotta be very careful today. Moving forward on Friday. Job numbers are coming out. Talking about recovery plan, and also with the Delta variant going on. So we got to be very careful. If you see a pullback, that's why I'm saying that if we have a pullback, then we'll see somewhere dropping the stock price for XPeng or even NIO also in the EV sectors. But overall, I'm excited. I'm excited about the company's growth, right? The company's growth, you always want to see if this company is a rock solid or is just another scam. We know there was a 22% drop on XPeng due to there was a rumor on the delisting. Chinese gum stocks are going to be delisted due to SEC is looking requiring a balance sheet reports, which the companies are providing. The big companies like XPeng is providing them, so it's not a problem. I don't see it getting delisted. This company is rock solid, folks. So before I close out, moving forward, 41.49 is a very important support level. Right, all the way low of $39.04, $44.66, gotta break out, and then $46.89 will be the next resistance to break out. And our magic white line sitting at $51.95, right? Stay tuned for more videos. Apologies for sending out this video late, but I will keep posting it constantly on the X Bank. So stay tuned on that. Don't forget to subscribe and smash the like button. Thank you for watching.